Well, this Friday, Chicagoans are invited to a Latino Health Brain Summit hosted by Alzheimer's Foundation of America.
It's a virtual event that's completely free and filled with information from experts, impacted families, and local resources. Joining us now to talk a bit more about what to expect of and the importance of this event is Dr. David Marquez. He's a professor at UIC and the Rush Alzheimer's Disease Center. Dr. Marquez, thank you so much for joining us today.
Hey, doctor.
Yeah, pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So this is a really huge and important event, but why is it important to offer something like this, specifically, like we mentioned, Latino-based?
The biggest reason is that the prevalence and the risk of Alzheimer's disease is higher amongst Latinos than among non-Latino whites.
Oh.
And in addition, the rates are going to skyrocket over the next, say, 20, 30, 40 years, the number of Latinos with Alzheimer's.
Now, we mentioned that there's a gathering of the minds, if you will, experts, those impacted by it. Do you feel that this is an event truly for anyone, or should it be someone that considers himself an expert or directly impacted by it?
Oh, I think it's really could be open to anybody. Some of the information will apply directly to Latinos and bringing in cultural values and the way family plays a role. But some of it is more general to everybody. And it's said that Alzheimer's is progressing so fast across the United States. If you don't already know somebody with Alzheimer's, you are likely to be personally affected in some way in the near future.
Wow. And, you know, one of the things, too, like you had mentioned, you know, it's kind of for everybody. But what about those who are already dealing with a loved one or a close one who is already, you know, either already diagnosed with Alzheimer's or some way a likeness of that disease? Is this also for them? What are some of the benefits that they can gain out of this?
Yeah, absolutely. In that case, I think the summit is good for everybody. So we'll talk a bit about, you know, prevention, what we can do to reduce our risk, like being physically active and eating a healthy diet. Also signs and symptoms, right? What are some things to look for when somebody's cognition or memory seems to be changing? But also people who are currently affected. So what kinds of resources are available to help people through the their lives in caregiving and what resources might be available?
I'm most interested, as you mentioned, the odds are good that I will be personally impacted, whether it's myself or a family member, a friend, a loved one, et cetera. I'm most interested in what developments have taken place in the research side and the medication side, you know, addressing the problem of Alzheimer's. Is there anything along those lines that will be brought up and discussed at the health summit?
Yes, I believe so. What I've learned in my research with Alzheimer's disease, the researchers are really pretty selfless. And the focus is on no one person, no one researcher or university is going to solve the Alzheimer's problem by themselves. So there really is phenomenal collaboration with great minds around the country, really contributing to try to figure out how can we find a cure. Unfortunately, for quite a while now, 15 to 20 years there, before a recent drug, there hasn't been much approved by the FDA. And, you know, that has some people feeling, you know, a little bit down about that. But the research is really progressing. It is so complex that it's really difficult to find something quickly.
Yeah. And the thing with something like Alzheimer's, it's not reversible. And you know, something like that is still being worked on. But what about whether it's with patients that you see or in your studies, have you seen age range? I mean, are people getting younger when being diagnosed with something like this? I think when we think of Alzheimer's, we think of an older population. Mm-hmm. But I don't think it discriminates on age.
No, absolutely not. Unfortunately, not by age or race or creed or any of those. Age is the number one risk factor for Alzheimer's disease. So those who live to be 85 years old, you know, one in two will develop Alzheimer's disease. Yeah, so it is really quite prevalent. And that's why we try to focus on what can you do to reduce your risk? Really try to be physically active in any way you can to move your body, find what you like to do. Try your best to eat a healthy diet. Specifically, there's a MIND diet that was developed by Martha Claire Morris at Rush, really focusing on green leafy vegetables and other types of things, nuts and berries. And if you're using oils, try to use something like olive oil. Mm. The data is there that these are things that we can do. It's correct, like you mentioned, there is no cure and it's not reversible. So we really have to try to do our best up until that point so that we can really reduce our risk of getting.
Excellent. Well, we have some of the details of that virtual session for anybody that's looking to attend. 12 to 1 p.m. on the 23rd, they'll be giving out healthy living tips. And once again, this is all virtual, so you can attend from anywhere in Chicagoland or beyond for those watching outside of Chicago. And then from 1 to 4 o'clock on the 23rd, Health of Latinos, Culture Really Matters, Brain Health, Surviving or Thriving, having the conversation about Alzheimer's, and then Planning for the Future, Legal Tools for Patients and for Caregivers.
Amazing. Dr. Marquez, thank you so much for being with us. And we look forward to seeing what comes out of this panel and this summit.
Great. Thank you so much.